I am surrounded by vegetarians. They include the people I admire the most in the world. A quorum of my best friends, the person I am currently dating, Mr. Rogers, and my grandmother. And you know, they're right. Being a vegetarian is better for the environment, for your health, and, as my grandma puts it, for the cute faces of the animals. There was a point this fall where I decided that I didn't want my relationship with animals to include eating them anymore. Sort of. I decided to become a pescatarian because fish have these nifty omega-3s that'll prevent me from getting dementia, but that's beside the point. The point is that this plan failed. And I'd like to tell you that it failed for logistical reasons, that it was hard for me to get enough protein because I don't really like cheese, or that there weren't enough options when I was traveling and I could only find fast food. But that's not the whole truth. The truth is, I kind of missed meat. Or rather, I missed certain meals that involved meat. I went home for the holidays this winter, and there were certain dishes my family has been making for years that I kind of felt left out of. I've been thinking a lot recently about how hard it is to set goals, particularly when those goals involve multiple values that may not be in agreement with one another. For me, those values included family traditions, my own likes and dislikes, the animals, the planet, you know. Simple stuff. Obviously, I'm never going to be finished finding the balance between these things, but for now, I've decided. I'm not going to stop eating meat, but I'm going to eat less of it. And I'm going to make my choices based on what I know about myself. So, will I go for pork buns in Chinatown? Definitely. A BLT? Maybe on occasion. Bob Evans sausages? Not when the Morningstar vegetarian ones are just as good. Will I be as pure as my vegetarian friends? No. But I'm happy with myself for trying. Quick update, I have moved back to Chicago, where I went to college, and I've started a couple of new creative projects as well. One is a Twitter account where every day I post about a different historical peace treaty, and the second is a weekly show, a radio show on my old college station, where I interview a creative guest each week. I will link to both of those things down below. The first episode of my radio show, I interview my friend, fellow YouTuber, Teo of The Letter 15. You probably have heard of him. I think the better part of my subscribers come from him, so check that out. See you later.